walking through a town time has forgot. I'm in Arrow Rock, Missouri. Hey there, there's the bank. I just noticed the bank right there. And this town was on the Missouri River and basically is the real start of the Santa Fe Trail is here. You could catch it down in Lexington or farther west in Westport or even Independence. But this is where all the stuff came off of the Missouri River, all the goods for sale if you were going to travel west. And this is a town that kind of time has forgot. Look down at this, like look down here, this tavern. How incredible is this place? Okay, that's all I wanted to
do. You know what's neat about, like there's nobody here.
Well, that's what's cool to me, even today, me and you hanging out. It's like we're walking down the middle of the road. I mean, you know. Oh, I was going to, right here. Look at these steel.
Like shuttering or something.
Then look at this. Man, that's the real piece. Look at that. Steel shutters. Now, we've seen wood shutters like in other places for fire, but this is definitely for protection, right? That's incredible, that little, you know. I love these troughs, these ditches of rock. Been here for hundreds of years. How incredible is this place?
Arrow Rock, Missouri is one of the most fascinating places that feels like you've been lost in time. And here is some of the history from Arrow Rock's website. The Arrow Rock Bluff. For generations, the Arrow Rock Bluff was a significant landmark on the Missouri River for Native Americans, explorers, and westward travelers. This flint-bearing high limestone bluff first appeared in 1732 French map as the Pierre of la Flèche, literally translated Rock of Arrows. Archaeological evidence shows that for nearly 12,000 years, indigenous cultures used Arrow Rock Bluff as a manufacturing site for flint tools and weapons. Large numbers of immigrants from Kentucky, Tennessee, and Virginia began pouring in to the fertile Boonslick County, so named for the salt spring or lick across the river. The early 1820s. The earliest travelers on what became the Santa Fe Trail crossed the river on the Arrow Rock Ferry and filled the water barrels with fresh water as the big spring before heading west. In 1829, the town of Arrow Rock was founded on the bluff above the ferry crossing. Originally named Philadelphia, the town's name was changed in 1833 to coincide with the better-known landmark name Arrow Rock. Many citizens prominent in the state of national affairs were closely associated with Arrow Rock, including Dr. John Sappington of quinine fame and George Caleb Bingham, Missouri's preeminent artist of the mid-1800s. Three 19th century Missouri governors also came from Arrow Rock. The Civil War began. Arrow Rock had reached its peak population of 1,000. The region had decidedly Southern character, evidenced in its culture, politics, and architecture. One third of the Saline County's population was enslaved African Americans. The Civil War precipitated an economic decline from which Arrow Rock never fully recovered. Steamboats and river commerce gave way to railroads that bypassed the town. Two fires devastated the business district and the population dwindled to 400 by 1910. Today, 45 full-time and 33 part-time residents call Arrow Rock home. Prior to the Civil War, supplies, merchandise, people, and animals followed the route of the Santa Fe Trail from the Missouri River through Main Street, Arrow Rock's primary east-west artery. Consequently, commercial businesses were concentrated on the river end of town on both sides of Main Street, while churches and other institutional buildings were scattered throughout the community. Most properties in Arrow Rock were devoted to residential use. Prolific American painter George Caleb Bingham would grow into manhood in Arrow Rock. Newly married to his first wife, Sarah Hutchinson, he bought a lot and built his first home here in 1837. The house still stands on the corner of High and First Street and was designated a National Historic Landmark in 1965. Although Bingham would travel extensively in the United States and Europe during the decades to follow, he would always call Arrow Rock home. Beginning in the 1930s, there was a renewed appreciation for his work. Today, Bingham is counted among the greatest American painters of the 19th century.